Welcome to part two in our series that's profiling the Middle East. I'm so looking forward to this segment as Caroline and Lauren focus on Saudi Arabia and speak about their plans when it comes to attracting tourism and foreign investment, in particular with the Big Four project plan. This has got me curious. Caroline, take it away.
Now, Lauren, apart from the UAE, are there any other regions or countries, in your region, of course, any countries in your region in the Middle East who are focusing on boosting the economy with tourism and foreign investors, like, do you think?
Yes.
Yeah.
I have actually been researching a lot of the projects that they have going on in Saudi Arabia, and it's absolutely fantastic to see. It's actually been spoken about more and more now, but there are four massive projects, and these were announced by the Saudi Crown Prince in 2017-2018 for his Vision 2030 to attract foreign investors and tourism too. Okay. And they seem to be making great progress. The projects will drive tourism and businesses and investors to a new up-and-coming Saudi travel destination. That's their aim and their vision. So the first project that they are busy with is called NEOM. It's the Arabic word for new future. And it's a project that's located in Tabuk in the northwest region in Saudi. It's a $500 billion Saudi mega city that they're building, which they say is going to be 33 times the size of New York City and 35 times the size of Singapore. And they expect to have it completed by 2025.
Amazing. Amazing figures. That's really amazing. So do you think then Saudi Arabia is the place to be in the future?
I don't see a reason why it couldn't definitely take over as a big tourism drive. And definitely, you know, from what I've seen on these projects, it looks like a place that you would just want to go on a holiday to start off with, to see what it's like over there. I've always been particularly intrigued by Saudi Arabia anyway. And some of the other projects that they have, I mean, they've got this Saudi Red Sea tourism project, and that plans to have 16 hotels on five islands by 2023 to obviously attract tourists, and it'll be a luxury destination.
Wow.
And then they have the Amala project, which is the Arabic word for hope. And that's putting Saudi Arabia on the jet set map and focuses on arts and culture, wellness and sports, and sun, sea, and lifestyle. Mm. It's planning to boast over 800 villas and 2,500 hotel rooms.
Amazing. Mm.
And the last project that they have is called Al Qadir, which is focusing on creating a richer life for Saudi citizens. So as you can see, Caroline, with all of these projects going on in Saudi, it's definitely going to drive people in, I feel. They've already started relaxing rules for women having visas to go on their own, unaccompanied, into Saudi Arabia. Obviously, the worldwide news that hit the world stage was that women can now obtain their driver's license and drive in Saudi Arabia. There's some massive changes going on in Saudi, and I just really think that it will keep getting better and better over there, and more open to having loads of expatriates over, whether it be for holidays or to move there.
Well, it sounds very exciting, actually, you know, and I can even picture myself going there on a vacation. Look forward to that.
Yeah.
Okay, Lauren, you sold me. Caroline, I'm going with you on that vacation, girl. When do we start packing? It's unbelievable what's happening in the Middle East. Can it get any better? Well, I'm hearing rumors about a big global fair happening in the United Arab Emirates, and I'm clicking the link to learn more as we profile the Middle East with Caroline and Lauren, and I suggest you click also.